This is a luxury yacht hotel, and tonight I'm going to be staying on it. This is one of the world's most unique hotels. We're going to be checking out the rooms, the yachts, and also the food. The reviews are very, very good, but let's see what it is really like.
So here it is, the Sunborn London, the super yacht hotel. This thing is absolutely huge, and from the outside, it is genuinely a thing of beauty. Just look how long this yacht is. So as you can see, some of the rooms don't have balconies and some of them do. I have no idea what we have booked. I believe we've got a view of the Docklands though and not this view. Hopefully that is the case.
I am really excited for this. Let's go and check in.
So we made our way inside and went straight to check in.
I think the reception's on the first floor. Look at the gold. We're living it up, you know. We're posh.
Reception 3.
Look how posh this is for a lift. We've got gold everywhere.
Oh my God. Hello, checking in please.
So we're all checked in. We are heading to our room now. This just feels really, really posh. There's gold everywhere. Hopefully the room is good.
340.
This is our room here.
Let's have a look.
You know what? This is really nice. Nah, this is nice, you know? This is beautiful. The room, it did look nice, but a lot of the furniture was quite old. FlexiSpot could help with that. Their X7 recliner would be a great option for a new chair. The expertly designed recliner gives a supportive and luxurious seating experience. It's made out of high quality real leather, so it means maintenance is easy. Its high quality filling makes it durable, super soft, and stress easing. It has two separate motors, one for the backrest and one for the integrated footrest. You can control each one independently. Its whisper quiet operation and 270 degree swivel ensure your relaxing time goes uninterrupted. Also, the sturdy iron frame ensures reliable stability. It can handle a load of up to 136 kilograms. It also contains a USB charger, so you don't even have to leave your seat anymore to charge devices. Click the link in the description to get a recliner for yourself. Get up to 50% off in their 8th anniversary promotions throughout August, so head over to the FlexiSpot website.
So welcome to the room. Can't lie, this room has actually surprised me. I didn't think it would be as nice as this. So let's have a look around the room. This is the view you've got as you come in. And straight away, you have got a king size bed, I believe it is. Absolutely massive.
I mean, it can fit a 6-foot giant on it. So you know it's got to be big.
It is quite comfy as well. Obviously, you've got your bedside tables, which are decorated pretty nicely. We got anything in there? No. Couple of lights and a picture of Canary Wharf. Then you've got a place to put all your like bags and stuff, which as you can see we have used. And then this is a bit of a weird mirror, I can't lie. It's absolutely huge as you can see, but one of the things about it is you literally wake up and see yourself. It's a little bit weird. Anyway, moving on from that strange feature, we have got a little like table and chair area. And this thing, it just screams like wealth. You've got gold all along the outside. I tell you what, there is a lot of gold in this room. The lamps are also gold. But yeah, massive sofa where you can watch a bit of TV. This kind of section where the sofa and TV is, it is kind of separate from like the bed. So it's like you've got two sections to the room. And then below the TV, we have got amenities. Oh, for God's sake, I actually struggle with English. We've got a mini fridge with two boxes of water in. Now, I don't want to touch these because I feel like I'll get charged like £5 each. Don't know if they're complimentary. I'm a little bit scared. Do I touch it? I think they might be complimentary, but I don't want to chance it. Then next to it, we have got cups and then obviously a kettle. teas, coffees. Now, you actually get coffee pods in this room, and they can obviously be used for this little thing, a coffee machine. That is a nice little addition to the room. That brings us nicely onto the desk area.
So if you want to do a bit of work, get your laptop out. Nice little area to do it in.
It started beeping at me. I hope someone's not coming to the room. I almost forgot, we have got two little glass cups in this massive glass cabinet. Kind of don't think they needed to do the cabinet that big. Let me just show you the bathroom quickly. Obviously toilet, shower, little mirror, another mirror, and then a sink. Now this sink has got the most unnecessary golden parts to it. Why are they actually there?
We've still got so much more of the room to see, and we still have to try the food and explore the rest of the yacht. The next place we headed to was the bar. It was quite pricey, £8.44 for one drink.
Look how beautiful the reception area is. Big chandelier up there. It feels really, really posh on her. There's also this little lounge area in the reception with a view, obviously out onto the river.
So you can just sit here and just relax with a dock view.
Of course, you had the restaurant that served evening meals and breakfasts. But apart from that, there wasn't really much else there. Let's head back to the room.
So the receptionist actually said to us she had given us an upgrade. Originally we had a room with a porthole window, and instead we have now got a balcony.
As soon as you come into the room, you see the view. And to be fair, a view of the Docklands, it's not bad. Obviously the view of the Thames, it's not going to be beautiful because it is filthy. Let's go out and have a look. There is literally nothing on it. No chairs whatsoever. But what a view that is of Canary Wharf. That is beautiful.
Oh, and one last thing. The hotel is right at the end of a runway. The room is also pretty big. For the price as well, it's really good, I can't lie. The only way you know you're on a boat is by the bathroom door. Ugh, it weighs a ton.
And I very nearly missed these wardrobes. What have we got? We've got a safe, an ironing board, and a couple of robes.
Another weird feature was that the room had European plug sockets. Very strange.
Here it is at night, all lit up.
So this actually cost $67 million to buy, which is just insane. As I said earlier, there is a restaurant on board, so I thought we'd have a look at the prices.
Sourdough bread, £5.50. Fish and chips, £22. Who is paying £22 for fish and chips? To be fair, you do get some chunky chips.
That's worth it.
A farmhouse cheese selection with fruit, grapes and biscuits. Yeah, go on then, have a guess, have a guess.
£6.70.
£19.50.
I'm just gonna stick to spoons.
I couldn't handle reading them prices anymore, so I headed to bed.
So breakfast is actually included in the room. It is a cooked and a continental breakfast, so we'll see what it's like.
So we headed to the restaurant to check out breakfast. Obviously, you had a variety of drinks, cereals, fruits, there was yogurts, cheeses, and also salmon. Then you had a range of pastries, and finally, you had your cooked breakfast items. It was all really nice, and the view we had from our table wasn't bad either.
Right, it's time to check out. It's actually been a really, really nice room. Cannot complain whatsoever.
Genuinely, it was
a really, really good hotel. Really enjoyed my stay there.
How much did it cost? We paid £117.61. For London, that is a really good price. It was definitely a unique experience. And honestly, I thought the hotel was really, really nice.